Welcome to worship with Faith Lutheran in Staples and Bethany Lutheran in Cushing. So glad you can join us for worship. My name is Pastor Chris Matheson, and it's just a blessing to worship with you. Today we want to give thanks for those who are helping with the recording. We want to give thanks for Jerry and Brianna for recording today and for John for editing, and give thanks for Sandy and the online choir for their music. I want to give thanks for your continued financial support, reminders that your offering can be mailed to the churches, and so thank you for that support. With that, we'll begin our time of worship this first Sunday of Advent. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who alone does wondrous things. Blessed be God's name forever. Amen. Beloved, now is the time to wake from sleep. Let us confront our sins and confess them to the one who is merciful and just. God of new beginnings, we confess that we have not welcomed your holy reign. We have strayed from your path. We prepare for war instead of peace. We dishonor one another and your creation. Purify us with your refining fire and set us again on your way of love, that we may bear fruit worthy of repentance and welcome your coming among us. Amen. People of God, a new thing is growing in our midst, a tender branch, a living sign. By water and the Spirit, you are joined to this wonder. You have put on Christ, and your sins have been washed away. Rejoice in the way of the Lord. Amen. Praise to you, O God, our salvation, who is near. You hold us in our waiting and keep us awake to the world. You show up in our lives at unexpected times. Now bless us as we light this candle to keep our vigil for your arrival. We trust that even though we do not know the day or the hour, you hurry to gather all the people to your peace. Amen. Let us pray. Stir up your power, Lord Christ, and come. By your merciful protection, save us from the threatening dangers of our sin and enliven our walk in the way of your salvation. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. A reading from Isaiah, the second chapter. The word that Isaiah, son of Amos, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. In the days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established as the highest of the mountains, and shall be raised from the hills. All the nations shall stream to it. Many people shall come and say, "Come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, for he may teach us his ways, and that we may walk in his paths." For out of Zion shall go forth instruction, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations, and shall arbitrate for many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall lift up sword against nation. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, and neither shall they learn war any more. O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God. Now we read Psalm 122. I was glad when they said to me, "Let us go to the house of the Lord." Our feet are standing within your gates, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem, built as a city that is bound firmly together. To it the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord, as was decreed for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord. For there the thrones for judgment were set up, and the thrones of the house of David. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May they prosper who love you. Peace be within your walls, and security within your towers. And now a reading from Paul's letter to the Romans, the 13th chapter. Besides this, you know what time it is, how it is now the moment for you to wake from sleep. For salvation is nearer to us now than when we became believers. The night is far gone, the day is near. Let us then lay aside the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us live honorably as in the day, not reveling and drunkenness, not in debauchery and licentiousness, not in quarreling and jealousy. Instead, put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to gratify its desires. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God. Gospel according to Matthew, the 24th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. But about that day and hour no one knows, neither the angels of heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. For as the days of Noah were, so will be the coming of the Son of Man. For as in those days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day Noah entered the ark. And they knew nothing until the flood came and swept them all away. so too will be the coming of the Son of Man. When two will be in the field, and one will be taken, and one will be left. And two women will be grinding meal together, one will be taken, and one will be left. Keep awake, therefore, for you do not know on what day your Lord is coming. But understand this, if the owner of the house had known in what part of the night the thief was coming, he would have stayed awake, and would not have let his house be broken into. Therefore you must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an unexpected hour. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace and peace to you from God our Father, from Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Today we think about getting prepared. And this past week has been full of preparation. How much work does it take to get ready for Thanksgiving? There's shopping, there's cleaning, there's baking, there's cooking. And the grocery stores were busy. Extra food bought for extra people. And then, not so long ago, how much preparation was there getting ready for deer season? Getting a license, getting food to eat, getting the good clothing to stay warm in the cold. And then there's the preparing of dreaming about seeing that perfect trophy buck. And then there are those who prepare for Black Sunday, Black Friday shopping, when stores open up. And so people make preparation. Where will they go? When will they get there? Lists of presents are made, maybe even something for yourself. But do some people just stay home in their pajamas and order their gifts on the computer? I bet some might this year too. But through it all, prepare, prepare, prepare. Today is the first Sunday of Advent, and so we seek to prepare for the return of our Lord Jesus Christ. First, we remember that our whole life as a Christian is about following Jesus. Our whole life should be about preparing for Jesus' return. But the truth is, most people, those who are faithful followers and those who aren't, most people are looking at this time of year from Thanksgiving to Christmas as a time of nostalgia, to think about past time. Or it's a time to get gifts to celebrate this year. Or it's a time to get together with friends and family for work parties and all sorts of Christmas parties and celebrations. Now, first off, it is good for us to celebrate. We need to find places to have fun, to find reasons to get together with others and enjoy their company. So I hope you do take time and enjoy your preparations for Advent, for Christmas, for preparing to get together with family, and make intentional time to be with those you care about. The problem is sometimes it gets to be too much. We start to have just too many good things. And instead of these things being a joy, they become a burden. Too many Christmas concerts to go to. Too many Christmas parties to attend. Too many gift exchanges. And so the busyness of the season gets to just be overwhelming to us. Gifts are a blessing, but we can worry about it too much. Do we spend too much? And do we make the gift that center of the season when it should be on something else? So this year, let me suggest that we can remember the true reason for the season. We prepare to celebrate Jesus' birth. And the best way to do that is to worship our God. And so we gather each Sunday here in Advent as we prepare for Christmas Eve. We take time to simply sit and pray, to not think about the busyness of the season, but instead to worship our Lord. But we also take time this time of year more than any other to prepare for Jesus' return. And now none of us knows when Jesus will return. Because of that, we should be ready each day. We should live lives that are a preparation for Jesus to come at any time. And so when we think about Christmas, we think about what Jesus would want for us. Do we, this Christmas season, seek to forgive, to care for the sick, think about and care for the poor? Do we remember the refugee, those who have been chased from their home? Do we seek this time, like all times, to be honest in our dealings with others? Do we even admit our mistakes, even when it costs us? This year, like many others, there is much darkness in the world. People face so many challenges, from gun violence to depression, to addiction, to loneliness, health issues, financial struggles, family conflict, or a changing world. There are so many things in this world that can cause us to wonder. It can be easy for us to pull back, to just think about ourselves, think about our needs and our immediate family. But this Advent, we remember that it is a season defined by light. Each week, we light another candle as we move towards Christmas. And we need that light because the world outside is dark. The days have gotten shorter, and the darkness seems to grow. And so we light candles here in church and in our homes to remind ourselves of the light of Christ, to remember that Jesus makes a difference in our lives. And we give thanks that Jesus changes our lives, but others' lives as well, and through us and others changes this world. And so we seek to follow Jesus, and we seek to do it by loving our neighbor. We know that incredible things can happen. When we care for others, we are better able to keep our lives in perspective. By sharing what we have, we learn to appreciate what we have instead of desiring what others have. And so this year, I encourage you to enjoy this season of light. So look around and give thanks for Christmas decorations, for Christmas lights and celebrations of all kinds. We can celebrate with cookies and hot chocolate. So enjoy. But every so often, take time to stop and remember. We prepare to celebrate Jesus' birth. What is more, we prepare for Jesus' return. And so today we ask this question: how did we prepare for Jesus' return? Amen. let us confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now we pray. As we prepare for the fullness of Christ's presence, let us pray for the world that yearns for hope. God of all creation, your children cry out for mercy. Awaken your church to the needs of our time. Break down barriers of culture and custom, and help us to unite in your redemptive and healing work. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of wonder, the earth's beauty and abundance is your gift. Teach us to share and to care for all life. And so, Lord, we remember those wild places that exist. Help us to care for your creation and protect all those things that are in danger. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of peace, you judge the nations. Lord, help us as we seek to beat weapons into tools to serve our neighbor. Strengthen the resolve of all who work for the end of war. And we pray for lasting peace in all the lands. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of loving kindness, you desire fullness of life for everyone. Fill those who hunger. Comfort those who grieve. Attend to those near death. Bring help and healing to all who are sick, all who are lonely. Lord, be with us in this holy time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of community, you are present whenever we gather in your name. Guide your churches. Help us in the midst of all things. Give us wisdom in our leadership and our leaders. Help us to see new opportunities to share your good news. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious God, in this time of COVID, we pray for your healing to be with all those who are impacted. We pray for doctors and nurses and hospital staff. We pray for those who work with the aged, and we pray for those who work with the young. And Lord, in this time of warfare, we pray for peace and ask your peace and justice come to Ukraine and Yemen, Ethiopia and Syria. Lord, wherever there is violence, we pray for peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, I promise your goodness is everlasting. We give thanks for the lives of the faithful who now rest in your care. And we trust that you will bring us into the great company of all the saints who rejoice in you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of our longing, you know our deepest needs. By your Spirit, gather our prayers and join them with the prayers of all your followers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always, and also with you. We now have a time of offering where we take the gifts that God has given us and we share them. We share them with the church and we share them with the world in need. And so thank you for your gifts to your church. Let us pray. God of our waiting and watching, we offer the gifts of our hearts and our lives to the service of all your people. Prepare the way before us as we celebrate your advent among us. Through Christ Jesus, our pathway and our peace. Amen. Let us pray. Praise and thanks to you, Holy God, for by your word you made all things. You spoke light into darkness, called forth beauty from chaos, brought life into being. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. By your word, you called your people Israel to tell of your wonderful gifts, freedom from captivity, water on the desert journey, a pathway home from exile, wisdom for life with you. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Through Jesus, your word made flesh, you speak to us and call us to witness. Forgiveness through the cross, life to those entombed by death, the way of your self-giving love. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Send your spirit of truth, O God, rekindle your gifts within us, renew our faith, increase our hope, deepen our love, for the sake of the world in need. Faithful to your word, O God, draw near to all who call on you, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now hear God's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
Thank you.
Go in peace. Be a blessing to the world. Thanks be to God.